The choir of the Cathedral of Christ the Living Saviour presents Hallelujah, a festival of choirs featuring Asteria the Female Voice Choir, Bishop's College PPA Choir, Choro Benedicte, Ladies College OGA Choir, Menaka Singers, Metto Cantanti, Noted, Sangeet, the Lily Godridge Singers, the Old Joe's Choir, the Peterite Chorale, and the Revelations.
Good evening, everyone, and a warm welcome as we gather together for Hallelujah, a festival of choirs presented by the choir of the cathedral together with 12 other choirs that have accepted our invitation and joined us this evening. And so we begin by thanking the 12 choirs for their presence and participation this evening. The choirs being Asteria Female Voice Choir, Bishop's College PPA Choir, Choro Benedicte, Ladies College OGA Choir, Menaka Singers, Metto Cantanti, Noted, Sangeet, the Lily Godridge Singers, the Old Joe's Choir, the Peterite Chorale, the Revelations, and our own Cathedral Choir. We thank all of you who have gathered here in this cathedral this evening as we continue in this year of our Jubilee, where we have been having a series of events, and this being one of them. I take this opportunity to thank the institutions and individuals who have made this evening possible for us. The Delano Brothers, C2S.LK, our print media sponsors, Daily Mirror, Sunday Times, Daily FT, Hi, our radio sponsors, EFM, our television sponsors, Dialogue TV, and Asiri Hospitals, which have kindly consented to provide us with a doctor on call and an ambulance for this evening. I also want to take the opportunity to thank our team of ushers and our logistics team who have played an important part in preparing and assisting us with the preparations for tonight. And this is a group second to none and absolutely professional in their outlook. And I am happy to say that if anyone wants their assistance, we will be very happy to share them with you. Thank you also to Kishan Pereira of Unique Sounds and his team for D4 led by Danushka for the lights, Kenoma Creations led by Jayalath, who is videoing the event, which can be viewed on the screens right around the cathedral. We thank Savitri Rodrigo and my good friend Kumar De Silva, together with Niranjan De Silva, for their input to making this evening a joyful and a memorable one. For everyone in this year of our Jubilee, and for the committee that is making these arrangements, I want to thank you, particularly the team that has taken care of this evening's arrangements, headed by Ishan Dilanarol himself and Ramola Sivasundaram. I also want to thank the diocesan office for sharing gardeners with us to do a lot of the work that was required, and our two church caretakers. Between them, there is sufficient wisdom to rule the world. David and Solomon are their names, and I thank them for their unstinted support and commitment. May we look to God in prayer. Gracious God, to whom we celebrate the dedication of this house of prayer, we praise you for the many blessings you have given to those who worship you here. And we pray that all who seek you in this place may find you. And each being filled with the Holy Spirit, may become a living temple acceptable to you through Jesus Christ our Lord, to whom with you and the Holy Spirit be glory and honor. Amen.
The Ladies' College choral tradition spans over 90 years and is firmly rooted in the daily chapel services that are in an integral part of the school. All members of the OGA choir have been committed choristers throughout their school careers. The choir consists of a wide spectrum of generations from diverse walks of life, united by their love for singing and the school. All principals and teachers have contributed to creating a strong musical tradition at Ladies' College over the years. Many past choristers have excelled in the field of music nationally and internationally and have pursued careers in music. The OGA choir sings for important events in the OGA calendar, which has included significant fundraisers for the school. They also participated in the Asia Pacific Choir Games in 2017, held in Colombo. While sacred music is at the very foundation of the choir's repertoire, secular popular genres have also been explored over the years. The choir was founded by Mrs. Christine Pereira and is currently directed by Sureka Amerasinghe. This evening, they will be singing All Things Bright and Beautiful by John Rutter. One family, unbroken. We join with one acclaim, one heart, one voice uplifting to glorify thy name.
The reading is taken from Psalms 104, verses 24 to 31. How many are your works, Lord? In wisdom you made them all. The earth is full of your creatures. There is the sea, vast and spacious, teeming with creatures beyond number, living things both large and small. There the ships go to and fro, in Leviathan which you formed to frolic there. All creatures look to you to give them their food at the proper time. When you give it to them, they gather it up. When you open your hand, they are satisfied with good things. When you hide your face, they are terrified. When you take away their breath, they die and they return to dust. When you send your spirit, they are created. When you renew the face of the ground, may the glory of the Lord endure forever. May the Lord rejoice in his works. This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. Our next performance is by Noted, the all-female ensemble, which began in 2015 with a group of young adults who had all sung together in the choir of Methodist College Colombo under the direction of Sanjeev Jayaratnam. Noted was placed first in the Champions competition for chamber choirs at the 4th Asia Pacific Choir Games held in Colombo in 2017. The choir was then ranked 26th in the world among chamber choirs and 166th among the top 1,000 choirs in the world. Noted is directed by Sanjeev Jayaratnam, and they sing today, My Soul's Being Anchored in the Lord by Moses Hogan.
The reading is taken from the book of Hebrews, chapter 6, verses 19 and 20. We have this hope as an anchor for the soul, firm and secure. It enters the inner sanctuary behind the curtain, where our forerunner, Jesus, has entered on our behalf. He has become a high priest forever in the order of Melchizedek. This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. Benedicte is a premier all-male choral and vocal ensemble of Sri Lanka, comprising trained, experienced past products of St. Benedict's College, Colombo. They're a group of men volunteering from all walks of life with varying degrees of musical talent and experience, with passion, commitment, and flair for singing. Directed by Krishan Rodrigo, Choro Benedicte expects to create an extraordinary musical experience and touch hearts through their rendition of A Mighty Fortress Is Our God. The choir today is directed, as I mentioned, by Krishan Rodrigo, conducted by Dave DeVisa.
The Bible reading is taken from Psalm 91, verses 1 to 6. Whoever dwells in the shelter of the Most High will rest in the shadows of the Almighty. I will say to the Lord, He is my refuge and my fortress, my God in whom I trust. Surely He will save you from the fowler's snare and from the deadly pestilence. He will cover you with His feathers, and under His wings you will find refuge. His faithfulness will be your shield and your rampart. You will not fear the terror of the night, nor the arrow that flies by day, nor the pestilence that stalks in the darkness, nor the plague that destroys at midday. This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God.
A small change. The choir will be conducted by Krishan Rodrigo himself.
Thank you.
Ladies and gentlemen, if you know a bishopian, and I'm sure you all do, you know that she almost always carries a song in her heart. The Bishop's College PPA continues to strive to continue the school's rich legacy of music by bringing together the PPA choir as often as possible. This evening, they share with you a message of hope as our nation slowly begins to rise above the uncertainty and the instability that has battered us these past few years. We ask you to remember, O qua galakwe, there is love. And when there is love, there is forgiveness. It comforts the sick, it breaks the proud, and raises the meek. Life holds no guarantees, but there is always love. And this was Jesus' gift to us, paid in full on the cross. Written by Carey Pierce and arranged by the inimitable Tom Fetke, first performed by Chris Tomlins and the Watertoo Children's Choir, a choir made up of Ugandan AIDS orphans, we share with you their message of hope, Love, by Chris Tomlins.
The reading is taken from St. Paul's first letter to the Corinthians, chapter 13, reading from verses 4 to 8. Love is patient. Love is kind. It does not envy. It does not boast. It is not proud. It does not dishonor others. It is not self-seeking. It is not easily angered. It keeps no record of wrongs. Love does not delight in evil, but rejoices with the truth. It always protects, always trusts, always hopes, always perseveres. Love never fails. But where there are prophecies, they will cease. Where there are tongues, they will be stilled. Where there is knowledge, it will pass away. This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God.
Oh, Guadalupe,
Menaka Singers is essentially a group of students pursuing vocal training at the Menaka Sahabandhu School of Music. In the years 2005, 2007, 2008, 2011, 2012, 2018 and 2022, the choir had the honor of being invited to perform with the Symphony Orchestra of Sri Lanka at their gala Christmas carols and their concerts. Other performances with the Symphony Orchestra include a performance of Verdi's Requiem in 2009 and the Opera Choruses concert in 2014 conducted by Gregory Rose. In 2016 and 2017, they were part of the chorus for Beethoven's Mass in C and Mozart's Coronation Mass, both conducted by Gregory Rose. Menaka Singers have also performed at many concerts, corporate and private events, including Christmas performances at the Lanka Oberoi. Some Enchanted Evening and Allegro Tango, the September Song and Celebrating 30 are previous major concerts presented by Menaka Singers, from which the entire proceeds were donated to the Pediatric Ward of the Cancer Hospital Maharagama and the Lady Ridgeway Children's Hospital Colombo, respectively. In 2008, the Singers were invited to perform in the opera The Pearl Fishers by Bizet, directed by Patricia Panton and conducted by Benjamin Levi with an international cast. This subsequently saw an invitation to New Delhi in India to perform in two lavish productions, Carmen by Bizet and Sijetua Roy by Adam, directed by Patricia Penton and Jean-Francois Visinguera. These productions were organized by the Nimrana Music Foundation of India, Bonjour India, and the French Embassy in New Delhi. The formation of the Menaka Singers Opera Ensemble culminated with the participation in these international operas, and in subsequent years, the choir performed highlights from the operas Marriage by Figaro by W. Mozart, Sijetua Roy by Adolphe Adam, Barber of Seville by Rossini, and Carmen by Bizet. The choir will sing I Will Follow Him from Sister Act.
The Bible reading is taken from the Gospel of St. Matthew, chapter 4, verses 18 to 22. As Jesus was walking by the Sea of Galilee, he saw two brothers, Simon called Peter, and his brother Andrew. They were casting a net into the lake, for they were fishermen. Come, follow me, Jesus said, and I will send you out to fish for people. At once they left their nets and followed him. And going on from there, he saw two other brothers, James, son of Zebedee, and his brother John. They were in a boat with their father Zebedee, preparing their nets. Jesus called them, and immediately they left their boat and their father and followed him. This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God.
Follow him wherever he may go.
The history of the Peterite chorale goes back to 1992, when a group of dedicated past students attended the annual Peterite Easter Cantata presented by the college choir at the college chapel. The late very Reverend Father Joe Vikramasinghe, the rector at the time, suggested that they extend the musical and singing tradition of St. Peter's by taking part in future Easter cantatas. And with this was born the Peterite Chorale, with a maiden performance at the Peterite Easter Cantata in 1993 with just 12 members. The chorale was sustained and grew over the years under the able guidance and direction of Stefan Correa, from its inception to the formidable numbers that swelled its ranks with the passing of years. Throughout the years, it has grown steadily with ages ranging from 18 to 50 plus, and now boasts of a membership in excess of 60 under its current choral director, Sanjeev Dabare. A few of the current members were privileged to have their choral roots instilled by the late Father Clever Pereira, one of Sri Lanka's best known tenors, while others have passed through the tutelage of devoted teachers, the likes of Mrs. Astrid De Costa, Miss Noreen De Silva, and Mrs. Priyanti Senviratna Vendort. The chorale made its first public stage debut at Virtus and Veritas, a Diamond Jubilee concert of St. Peter's in 1997. While performing annually at the traditional Easter Cantata of St. Peter's, the chorale is also performed at many other events around Colombo, notably with the Symphony Orchestra of Sri Lanka at several of their annual Christmas concerts. In 2003, the chorale marked its 10th year with a grand musical show, two sell-out performances entitled A Decade Together Forever at the Lionel Bench. Later productions of the chorale included Resonance in 2009 and Legacy in 2013. And more recently, the chorale marked its 25th year with a well-attended Thanksgiving service in August 2018 at St. Mary's Church, Bumblepitia, collaborating with the Soul Sounds and St. Mary's Chorale Group. While the main lure of its membership is the love for music and the chance to stay connected with one's alma mater, camaraderie, friendship, the enjoyment of each other's company and pure joy of singing together is what makes the Peterite Chorale a group that is unique in its culture and will ensure it lives on through the multiple generations as it is now seen in its ranks.
The reading is taken from the Gospel according to St. John, chapter 5, verses 2 to 9. Now there is in Jerusalem, near the Sheep Gate, a pool, which in Aramaic is called Bethesda, and which is surrounded by five covered colonnades. Here a great number of disabled people used to lie, the blind, the lame, the paralyzed. One who was there had been an invalid for 38 years. When Jesus saw him lying there and learned that he had been in this condition for a long time, he asked him, "Do you want to get well?" "Sir," the invalid replied, "I have no one to help me into the pool when the water is stirred. While I am trying to get in, someone else goes down ahead of me." Then Jesus said to him, "Get up, pick up your mat, and walk." At once the man was cured. He picked up his mat and walked. The day on which this took place was a Sabbath. This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God.
Thank you. looks like the band that Moses led. God's gonna trouble the water. Look over yonder, what do you see? God's gonna trouble the water. The Holy Ghost is coming, come on me. God's gonna trouble the water.
Asturia was founded in 2010 when a group of passionate singers, coincidentally all past and present students of Methodist College Colombo, decided to put together a choir under the direction of the late Mahen Pieris. The female choir comprises singers of all ages, united in their love for singing, yet another unique feature. The choir is directed and trained by Prashalini Pieris, the wife of the late Mahen Pieris. Asturia continues to sing and experiment with new genres of music and has a wide repertoire of choral, spiritual, jazz, pop, and a cappella. Among its many achievements, the most significant would be the exposure and experience gained at the 4th Asia Pacific Choir Games 2017 held in Colombo. Asturia competed against many other Asian choirs at this competition and won 2 gold medals in the open category and a silver medal in the champions category. Tonight they perform Joyful, Joyful from Sister Act 2, Back in the Habit, adapted by Roger Emerson.
The Bible reading is taken from Psalm 98, verses 4 to 6. Shout for joy to the Lord, all the earth. Burst into jubilant song with music. Make music to the Lord with the harp and the sound of singing, with trumpets and the blast of the ram's horn. Shout for joy before the Lord, the King. This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God.
Of death. chorus, the mighty, mighty chorus, which the morning stars begin. The Father of God is reigning over us. He washes over everything, so we sing. Joyful, joyful, we adore Thee, God of glory, Lord.
Founded in 1962 by the late Kalasuri Lily Godrej and led now by his son Willie, the LJ Singers have been performing their trademark male voice a cappella for the last 61 years with very specific and singular purpose, to serve through song. Tonight they feature a version of the 23rd Psalm written and arranged by contemporary American composer Daniel E. Gothrop.
The Bible reading is taken from the Gospel according to St. John, chapter 10, verses 11 to 18. I am the good shepherd. The good shepherd lays down his life for the sheep. The hired hand is not the shepherd and does not own the sheep. So when he sees the wolf coming, he abandons the sheep and runs away. Then the wolf attacks the flock and scatters it. The man runs away because he is a hired hand and cares nothing for the sheep. I am the good shepherd. I know my sheep, and my sheep know me, just as the Father knows me. And I know the Father, and I lay down my life for the sheep. I have other sheep, and they are not of this sheep pen. I must bring them also. They too will listen to my voice, and there shall be one flock and one shepherd. The reason my Father loves me is that I lay down my life, only to take it up again. No one takes it from me, but I lay down of my own accord. I have authority to lay down and authority to take it up again. This command I received from my Father. This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God.
Yeah.
Metho Cantata is a past pupils choir of Methodist College, Colombo. Singing and music were an integral part of their lives during their school days at Methodist College. Brought together by their love for music, they continue to cherish and enjoy representing their alma mater in singing through this choral outfit. The choir was formed under the direction of Anagi Pereira in 2010 and was named Metho Cantanti, which is Italian for Metho Singers, in 2012. Currently, it is jointly directed by Anagi Pereira, Manika Beratna, and Rebecca Surendigaj. Metho Cantanti has a broad repertoire which includes classical, Broadway, gospel, and pop music. This evening, they will feature I Will Sing of Your Love, words and music by Joseph M. Martin, inspired by Psalm 101.
The Bible reading is taken from Psalm 101, verses 1 to 8. I will sing of your love and justice to you, Lord. I will sing praise. I will be careful to lead a blameless life. When will you come to me? I will conduct the affairs of my house with a blameless heart. I will not look for approval on anything that is vile. I hate what faithless people do. I will have no part in it. The perverse of heart shall be far from me. I will have nothing to do with what is evil. Whoever slanders their neighbor in secret, I will put to silence. Whoever has haughty eyes and a proud heart, I will not tolerate. My eyes will be on the faithful in the land, that they may dwell with me. The one whose walk is blameless will minister to me. No one who practices deceit will dwell in my house. No one who speaks falsely will stand in my presence. Every morning I will put to silence all the wicked in the land. I will cut off every evildoer from the city of the Lord. This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God.
Oh,
The Ojos Choir, or OJC, was formed in 1997, comprising past students of St. Joseph's College, Colombo, who have an undying passion of striving towards excellence in a variety of genres of choral music. Since its inception, the OJC has evolved and built a very strong reputation in Sri Lanka and across the world, having staged a series of successful concerts since its maiden concert in 1999. The OJC met with great success in Riga, Latvia, at the 2014 World Choir Games, where it was adjudged champions in the barbershop music category with a gold medal performance and silver medalists in the sacred music with accompaniment category. The OJC is regarded as a versatile and experienced choral ensemble, known to present a well-balanced mix of music genres catering to a wide range of audiences. The choir will sing "O Clap Your Hands," composed by Ralph Vaughan Williams and directed by Deshan Kure.
The Bible reading is taken from Psalm 47. Clap your hands, all you nations, and shout to God with cries of joy. For the Lord Most High is awesome, the great King all over the earth. He subdued nations under us, peoples under our feet. He chose our inheritance for us, the pride of Jacob, whom he loved. God has ascended amid shouts of joy, the Lord amid the sounding of trumpets. Sing praises to God, sing praises to our King, sing praises. For God is the King of all the earth. Sing to him a psalm of praise. God reigns over the nations. God is seated on his holy throne. The nobles of the nations assemble as the people of the God of Abraham. For the kings of the earth belong to God. He is greatly exalted. This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God.
Thank you.
The choir of the Cathedral of Christ the Living Saviour also celebrates 50 years of its existence. The dynamic Erdli Vijayavardhana was the first choir director from inception till his demise in June 1991. During his tenure, the choir was at a very high standard and the Adlam service setting was introduced. The carol services were exceptional. Erdli left behind a legacy of choir discipline, inspiration, and the highest standard of music. In January 1992, Mrs. Neela Silva, a chorister at the cathedral, was invited to take over as a choir director. While continuing the rich tradition of music, she introduced the Salisbury service setting and continued to take the choir to great heights. In 2012, on the invitation of Mrs. Neela Silva, the then Archdeacon and the Bishop, Ishan Dilanarol took over as choir director. The choir, apart from leading worship at Sunday services, also participated in many programs that led to their outreach ministry. One such event was a donation of pillows to the cancer hospital, whereby every patient was given a new pillow, as the choir realized this was the most treasured item for a terminally ill person who is confined to their bed. They discovered this when they made a donation of stretchers to the same hospital on an earlier occasion. The one-year remembrance service for the Easter bomb blast victims was yet another moving service by the choir. They've also had several Easter and Christmas cantatas and other musical programs at the cathedral, in Kandy and Gaul, some of them involving children from school choirs as well. In fact, the next program of the cathedral to celebrate 50 years will be the choir performing the musical Experiencing God, which will bring many school choirs together. It will take place on the 28th of October. All are welcome. Although she is not playing the organ today, we would like to acknowledge the services of Mrs. Blodwin de Silva as she continues with a 100% attendance record for the last 46 years. Could we please have a round of applause for her? Today, the choir will be accompanied by Mr. Niranjan de Silva at the organ and will lead the congregation in the hymn, How Great Thou Art, with which time an offertory will be taken.
Bible reading is taken from Psalm 8, verses 1 and 3 to 6. Lord, our Lord, how majestic is your name in all the earth. You have set your glory in the heavens. When I consider your heavens, the work of your fingers, the moon and the stars, which you have set in place, what is mankind that you are mindful of them, human beings that you care for them? You have made them a little lower than the angels and crowned them with glory and honor. You've made them the rulers over the works of your hands and put everything under their feet. This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. You're requested to please be seated during the next hymn, ladies and gentlemen.
This
Sangeet is a true community choir consisting of members of all religions, ethnicities, and backgrounds, with ages ranging from 15 to 55 years. The vision is to engage singers to experience high-quality choral music with performance opportunities in Sri Lanka and overseas. Directed by Sanjeev Jayaratnam, this evening they are singing The Irish Blessing with the harmonization written by James E. Moore Jr. The Irish Blessing is a prayer originally written in Gaelic, rich and symbolic in meaning. The author of the prayer isn't known for certain, although many attribute it to St. Patrick, as it is similar to his other writings.
The Bible reading is taken from the book of Numbers, chapter 6, verses 24 to 26. The Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord made his face shine on you and be gracious to you. And the Lord turns his face towards you and gives you peace. This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God.
The Revelations Male Vocal Ensemble was formed by a group of old boys of St. Thomas's College, Mount Lavinia, and had its first performance in 1994 at the Lionel Went. They were judged champions of the Asian Choir Games in the gospel category in Jakarta, Indonesia in 2007. And thereafter, adjudged world champions not once, but twice at the World Choir Games in the Austrian town of Graz in 2008. The Revelations were ranked number 4 in the world among male choirs in 2008. They have performed in Austria, China, Hong Kong, Malaysia, Singapore, and Indonesia over the years. They disbanded a few years ago, but are happy to be back singing for this celebration of choral music for the 50th anniversary of the Cathedral. The Revelations, conducted by Sanjeev Jayaratnam. A prayer in song that unites the world, they will sing the Lord's Prayer, arranged by Albert Hay Malott.
The Bible reading is taken from the book according to St. Matthew chapter 6, verses 5 to 8. And when you pray, do not be like the hypocrites, for they love to pray, standing in the synagogues and on the street corners to be seen by others. Truly I tell you, they have received their reward in full. But when you pray, go into your room, close the door, and pray to your Father who is unseen. Then your Father who sees what is done in secret will reward you. And when you pray, do not keep on babbling like pagans, for they think they will be heard because of their many words. Do not be like them, for your Father knows what you need before you ask him. This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God.
May we be quiet and look to God in prayer. All things come from you, O God, and of your own do we give you, Creator and Lord of the universe, ever adored to be worshipped. Accept these gifts which we present at your holy table, and with them the dedication of our lives for your service. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen.
The Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord make his face to shine upon you and be gracious unto you. The Lord lift up his countenance upon you and give you peace.
February 23, 1685, in Germany, but he spent the majority of his life in England. After living in England for the majority of his life, his love of music and composition was largely influenced by composer Henry Purcell. In his lifetime, Handel eloquently composed 42 operas, 29 oratorios, 16 organ concerti, over 120 cantatas, trios, and duets, and numerous arias, chamber music pieces, odes, and serenatas. Of his over 200 masterpieces, the most famous is The Messiah, which features the Hallelujah Chorus. The story of the Hallelujah Chorus is an interesting tale. First, the name is actually Hallelujah. However, as this portion of the highly acclaimed Messiah is typically played and heard separately, it has adopted the name of Hallelujah Chorus. In 1741, Handel composed The Messiah and what we know now as the Hallelujah Chorus. While designing and composing Messiah, Handel was in debt and deeply depressed. However, the masterpiece was completed in a mere 24 days. Despite his mental and financial state, the Hallelujah Chorus birth story is a glorious one. After Handel's assistant called for him for a few moments, the assistant went to Handel's work area because he received no response from Handel. Upon entering the room, the assistant saw tears emerge from Handel's eyes. When the assistant asked why Handel was crying, Handel proclaimed, "I have seen the face of God," while lifting up the composition of the Hallelujah Chorus, which ended up being the crowning achievement of his career. The Hallelujah Chorus has its own tradition that has endured over time. A standard practice is for the audience to stand while the portion of this Messiah is performed. This will also be the concluding performance at Hallelujah, the Festival of Choirs.
The Bible reading is taken from the book of Revelations, chapter 11, verses 15 to 19. The seventh angel sounded his trumpet, and there were loud voices in heaven, which said, "The kingdom of the world has become the kingdom of our Lord and of his Messiah, and he will reign forever and ever." And the 24 elders who were seated on their thrones before God fell on their faces and worshipped God, saying,
We give thanks to you, Lord God Almighty, the one who is and who was, because you've taken your great power and have begun to reign. The nations were angry and your wrath has come. The time has come for judging the dead and for rewarding your servants, the prophets and your people, who revere your name, both great and small, and for destroying those who destroy the earth. Then God's temple in heaven was opened, and within his temple was seen the ark of his covenant. And there came flashes of lightning, rumblings, peals of thunder, an earthquake, and severe hailstorm. This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. As Savi mentioned a little while ago, the Hallelujah Chorus has its own tradition which has endured time. A standard practice is for the audience to stand while this portion of the Messiah is performed, and all of you are most welcome to do so, ladies and gentlemen.